On the medical watch, COVID among LGBTQ people.
Yeah, WGN medical reporter Dina Baer is here with more on the launch of a local study. Dina?
We know certain groups are at greater risk for COVID-19, Latinx and African Americans among them. Now researchers say sexual and gender minorities may also have a higher likelihood for contracting SARS-CoV-2 and potentially experiencing worse outcomes.
We're now honing in on young gay and bisexual men and transgender women as a particular population to look at rates of infection with COVID.
Northwestern psychologist Dr. Brian Mostansky has been working with the LGBTQ community for his entire career. Now he's leading a study funded by the National Institutes of Health, one of the first to investigate COVID-19 exposure among young gay and bisexual men and transgender women. One health concern he's particularly interested in, inflammation, which can contribute to poorer outcomes when it comes to the virus.
Due to some of the stressors of discrimination and stigma, that gay and bisexual men have higher rates of inflammation in their body. The body can also produce a large inflammatory response in response to COVID. And therefore, if your baseline level of inflammation is already high, you might be at higher risk for developing that.
Smoking is another risk factor. Dr. Mostansky says compared to heterosexual men, gay and bisexual men are twice as likely to use cigarettes, vaping devices, and marijuana.
Smoking and vaping can put you at risk for a couple of reasons. One is that you actually have the effects of smoke inhalation in your lungs. That can cause lung damage. It might put you at more risk if you were to become infected with COVID.
The researchers will rely on antibody testing as a first step in the study. From there, they'll dig even deeper.
We're also going to be looking at whether people engaged in protective behaviors, like wearing masks when they went out, whether they were able to maintain social distancing or not, and look at whether some of those protective factors actually reduce the risk of having antibodies that show that you were infected with COVID.
Northwestern is home to the world's largest LGBTQ study center, and researchers hope to continue to mine data for years to come. You can learn more about this study on our website. We have a link. Back to you.